Subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to get all the latest updates.
Good afternoon, members of the press. It's good to see you all. After quite some time, personally, I would like to start the press conference, basically to apprise the press about the activities of the Economic Revival Committee. What are the objectives of the Economic Revival Committee? What are the methods we have used? And of course, what are the basic observations of the Economic Revival Committee? Basically, after the announcement by the Honorable Chief Minister, the Economic Revival Committee had its first meeting on the 18th. This was a preliminary meeting in order to chalk out what the activities of the Economic Revival Committee will be, how we will go forward, who are the stakeholders we will call, and that was the first meeting it was the meeting of the committee members itself. By now you are aware that who are the members of the Revival Committee. The first objective is basically to understand the economic loss and the disruptions which are caused because of this pandemic COVID-19. After gauging those losses, then we are trying to quantify those and say that how we can bring the economic activity to pre-COVID period. Okay. Then of course the third agenda is we take this crisis, I wouldn't say an opportunity, but we take this crisis to understand certain weaknesses of our industries, certain industry weaknesses of the sectors which are there, and thereafter propose with the collaboration and input from all the stakeholders, propose how we can strengthen and restructure. Okay, so basically it is to have a long-term view of the economic development in Sikkim and what will be the roadmap in the future. So these are the broad objectives which are there. So as you are aware, and some of my press friends are aware, that the methodology basically we are using it is to basically talk with stakeholders. Okay, and the first stakeholder, okay, I would say the biggest player, okay, is the government. Okay, so we have been talking with government departments, we have taken their input. Okay, so more or less we have finished off with all interactions with the government departments. From this week onwards we will be talking to the stakeholders. Okay, so there was this apprehension in the public domain that the Economic Revival Committee was not talking to the stakeholders, but that's not so. Okay, so we have a phased manner, we have been talking to government departments, and now the next phase is for stakeholders. The observations which are there is basically, which is very very apparent, is basically the biggest hit is for the tourism department. Okay, and in terms of the stakeholders of the tourism department, for example, hoteliers, restaurants. Okay, then of course the government also takes a hit in this because the collection of taxes, indirect taxes, go down, so the government also takes a hit. The second thing which is in the domain of excise. Okay, so there also the government all took a huge hit in terms of excise duty collection. Then of course land revenue department. Okay, because a lot of land transactions were not taking place. Okay, so there also we have a we have a shortfall in the revenue collection which is there. And of course, the not quantifiable but which is very very difficult for us, it is that the students community are now losing a lot of classes. Okay, so in terms of that, the HRD department has been very very pivotal in terms of making sure that students receive some amount of what do you call it, classroom interaction per se, but that is through online mechanism. Okay, we wouldn't the education department also believes that it is not enough. Okay, but in this situation, that is the best the education department could do. So when I earlier talked about how we are thinking about a long term plan, so it basically means that, for example, education department now has to restructure in terms of how education will be provided in the future. Okay, classroom, it can't so to speak replace classroom interaction, but it will have to bring in more technologies such that classroom what do you call, students education and students things are not disturbed to a large extent. Okay, interestingly, okay, these are observations, okay, these are not what do you call it, the findings. Or interestingly, we find that there is a jump in terms of agriculture activity. Okay, jump in terms of agriculture activity, because most of the people had gone back to villages and they started doing small farming activities which are there. So there's a jump in terms of agriculture activity. Animal husbandry, we are not very sure. Okay, because most of the I would say the poultry farmers were badly hit. Okay, so we know for sure that a lot of poultry farmers are there in South Sikkim. Okay, so they were badly hit in terms of because of the COVID thing, there was a blockage on feed. Okay, so the market, in a sense, the market also collapsed because of total blockage. So animal husbandry and poultry farmers were badly hit. In terms of industries which are there, okay, we have some, the committee hasn't met the farmer companies. Okay, the biggest industries in Sikkim are farmer companies. The committee haven't met them as such. We'll be meeting them, but my personal view is that the farmer company hasn't been hit so much. Okay, if you look at farmer companies in Sikkim, and I was talking to informally with some of the farmer company executives, they said that the activity in Sikkim, okay, for farmer company has been better than the all India average. Okay, they are not all India average. If they are company comparing with other companies which were throughout India, so the activity is more or less normal for farmer companies in Sikkim. We haven't as such quantified the losses which are there, but in tourism sector, the losses are, I would say, in the region of around about 500. This is a very very pessimistic 500 crores or so. This is a very very pessimistic kind of an estimate. Okay, so I am giving a tourism figure because tourism is the most affected. Okay, so this is the figure which is there. This is not the figure of the committee. This is just my personal figure. So I just wanted to share with you. So these are some of the things which we have done already. Now, just for your information, from 21st to 23rd of May, and from 28th to 30th of May, okay, we have more or less met with most of the departments. Like, just for your sake, we are saying education department, cooperative department, police department, information technology, national informatics center, power department, labor department, skill development, irrigation, PHE, land revenue, excise, transport department, agriculture and horticulture, animal husbandry and veterinary services, forest and environment, industry and commerce, tourism, UDNHD, food and civil supplies, RDD, health and social welfare. So these are the departments which we have met and we have interacted. The other stakeholders which we are planning to meet is on 4th, we are meeting with Sikkim Hotel and Restaurant Association, All Sikkim Travel and Hospitality Association, Sikkim United Tourism Organization, Travel Agent Association of Sikkim, Sikkim Association of Adventure Tour Operators, Sikkim Amateur Mountaineering Association, Sikkim Paragliding Association, Chamber of Commerce and Hotel Owners Association. So this is the schedule for 4th. On 5th, we are meeting entrepreneurs, okay, both online entrepreneurs as well as entrepreneurs, Marwari and Bihari associations, Lal Bazar supermarket traders, then of course pharma companies, executives of pharma companies, then of course distilleries and breweries also. On 6th, then we are meeting the banks, okay, lead banks, NABARD, Spices Board, OMAS also, okay, Chalak Morcha, Local Taxi Driver Association, Mainline Taxi Drivers, Truck Drivers Association. This is the schedule for 6th. On 8th, we are meeting Zilla and Upazilla Adyakshas for all districts, two representatives from GPUs also. So we want a representation from the grassroots level also. So we are meeting them also, BSNL and telecommunications, then vice chancellors of all universities. Then from the political party side, then we are meeting SKM, Sikkim Krantikari Morcha, represented from Sikkim Krantikari Morcha. On 9th, we are meeting Indian National Congress, Bharatiya Janata Party, SDF and Hamro Sikkim Party. So this is to bring in a flavor of what you call political parties and what they have to say in terms of this economic crisis which is now impending with us. So this is the activities which we are intended to do. Furthermore, there has been some apprehensions in the public domain that the committee is not able to meet everyone. True, okay, the committee can't meet each and everyone in Sikkim. This becomes a very cumbersome thing. Okay, so what we have done is that there is a WhatsApp number, so you can send your comment through WhatsApp. Okay, there is a email address, so you can send your what you call views and opinions through email address. So because we will not be able to, because if you keep on having a meeting with each and everyone, this is difficult. Okay, it will take 1 year. Okay, but meetings won't get over. So we, in that respect, we are also using the social media platform so that we get input from all the stakeholders. So I will just spell out the email address which is there. So ercsikkim2020@gmail.com. Okay. So all comments, those who want to send, okay, as a public representative or as an individual, if you feel that something shouldn't be missed out, okay, they can send emails in this address. There's a WhatsApp number also. Okay, people can send comments, not comments but opinions, and they may be experts in their own field. They can send it to WhatsApp also. So the WhatsApp number is 9800079444. Okay, so they can send these things. This is all we have to say as a chairman of the committee. So I will end my press conference here. And of course, if there are any questions, your friends may ask us. Thank you.
So, Chairman, some very quick questions.
Yes.
So, what about the other sectors like health, which is one of the most hit during this pandemic? And other is the power generation sector, of which 40% during the by this pandemic, the 40% of its revenue is going to be lost for this academic, for this financial year. But how the committee will look into these sectors, because after tourism, our sector is one of the biggest revenue sectors for the state of Sikkim.
See, the committee is just a medium, okay, medium to take in whatever advice from the stakeholders. Okay, so what we intend to do is that we will meet all the stakeholders. Okay, so you talked in terms of power sector. Okay, so we are not sure about the exact numbers which are there. Okay, the exact numbers we are not sure. What we are saying is that it is very what you call interesting to note that people who come up with problems, okay, those who have said the problems, they have also given the solutions. Okay, like typically if you say tourism sector, okay, tourism sector has said that these are our problems, so they have the solutions for that also. Okay, so we are trying to incorporate those solutions. Okay, we as a committee, as an expert, we don't have anything to impose on any sector. Okay, we are just translating what the stakeholders want, and of course to bring structure into the whole revival thing. Okay.
Okay, sir. अभी तो पहले टूरिज्म सेक्टर में 500 करोड़ जैसी लोड आता था लॉस था तो अनुभव है अरे जैसे अब आप तो सेक्टर में एक्साइज एंड पावर आप अपने बंद कि यो सेक्टर में जो भी लॉस होने वाला
मैले अर्ग्यानिक भने अनि दिज आर नट अफिसियल फिगर्स आई जस्ट बिकज द प्रेस कन्फरेन्स अलिक फिका हुन्छ भनेर मैले यहाँ फिगर मात्रै दिएको होइन टुरिज्म तर एक्साइजमा कति एक्ज्याक्टली लस हुन्छ भनेर हामीलाई भन्छ सर सर यु थिङ्क
यसमा जो अहिले विष्णु भाइले क्वेसन रेज गर्नुभयो तपाईँले रेज गर्नुभएको थियो नाउ पावर सेक्टरमा इट इज ट्रु दि जेनरेसन पर से has not reduced. Generation is there, but the demand has come down because of the fear of the people. Number one, all the big factories and industries were partly closed in the other parts of the country. So the power demand has naturally come down. Now in the peak of summer also, people are afraid of using air conditioners, which is the main power guzzlers in the summer. People are using fans and all those things. So naturally the demand of the power has come down, and as a result the per unit sale of the power in the exchange, which in normal time they would have got 3 rupees or 3 rupees 50 paisa, they are now getting a price of say 2 rupees 30 paisa, 2 rupees 50, 60 paisa. So per unit maybe from 40 paisa to 70-80 paisa there is change in the loss of revenue, we can say. But this was only for an initial period of 1.5 months. Now as the lockdown has been in a phased manner been removed or unlocked by the central government, so in most part of the country all the major industries as well as the companies have started functioning. So the power consumption will definitely increase, and maybe the initial loss of 1 or 2 months which they faced may be compensated in the subsequent period of the winter and other thing. So we have to wait and watch. We cannot extrapolate at the moment that overall this is the scenario for the whole year. This was a phase, business has come down, activities have come down. But maybe to compensate that, they may increase in the subsequent times to come. So that may, we have to wait, keep our fingers crossed and hope also that these demand increase. Similarly, excise, what you said, initial month around 1.5 months the excise shops were closed. But you see, though Sikkim has not done till now, but other states have increased their excise duty and revenue on these things ranging from 30% to 70%. So whatever the loss was there in 1.5 months, that has been more or less compensated in the bigger states. And in the fear that the shops will again be closed, people have purchased in bulk also and stocked also. So maybe in my opinion, the excise people are not in a loss. Maybe distilleries and other things, there was some restrictions on the movement of the goods, so the extra neutral alcohol which comes to the state from other parts of the country, their supply must have been disrupted and their production must have come down. But we hope that we gradually pick up. But as sir has told, the overall loss in the GSDP for the first 2 or 3 months, 2.5 months we can say, we are calculating, we will come with a figure in our report at a particular time. But we are all full of optimism and we hope that the things will catch up in the near future and the economy will be on its track. Moreover, the government of India has announced a huge package of 20 lakh crore, mostly in the forms of loans and assistance. No direct benefit is there. So those entrepreneurs who can want to take advantage of that, they are in a position to take that advantage. So our idea will also be to make our entrepreneurs and agencies aware about these schemes and programs through various departments so that they take full advantage of the situation, because many a time we all know ignorance is bliss. We are not aware because we are generally used to follow the path of least resistance. So when everything comes on the platter, why work hard for that? So now our idea is to make through the concerned department the benefits which is available and how they can tap it from the various resources.
Sir, my question. Yeah.
To all my press friends, can you please identify yourself before you shoot the questions? Thank you.
Vishnu Sahab is from Summit Time.
Oh, thank you.
Good evening. I'm Nirmal and I'm from Sikkim Chronicle. Sir, my question pertains with the unemployment index. Before I shoot my question, I would like to refer to reports of Center for Monitoring Indian Economy, CMIE. This report is of April and it states that Sikkim's unemployment rate hit a 8-month low of 2.3 in April 2020, according to a survey conducted by the Center for Monitoring Indian Economy. Over a longer period, unemployment has moved from 9% in February 2020 to its current rate. Unemployment in Sikkim was less than the national rate of 23.5%. This is a report of the month of April. Now, I have a CMIE report of the month of May, which categorically and specifically mentions that unemployment in Sikkim increased 22.2 PCT points, rose to 24.5% in May 2020 CMI, and which also states that the unemployment in Sikkim is now has been greater than the national unemployment rate of 23.5%. These both reports have come when there was a complete lockdown in most of the states in the country. Now, since we can correlate revival of the economy with the unemployment and employment, my question is because many Sikkimese people, they have left a job from other states and they have now come back to the state of Sikkim, many skilled, many unskilled workers. What do you think, what would be the recommendation of the Economic Revival Committee in terms of tackling, the unemployment, which in fact will be a very daunting task both for the state government and the, stakeholders, because we know many people are losing their jobs because of closure of the establishment, which directly relates with the hospitality and tourism industry. So what is a committee's overview on this? I mean, how do you see this unemployment index, especially post-pandemic situation?
See, of course, it's no surprise that the unemployment rate has increased. Okay, so this is a national and a global trend, so to speak. But just aside the point, when I was earlier talking about that agriculture activity has gone up, so it means that the economic activity is there in terms of agriculture, but it is not the data doesn't capture the employment which is there. Okay, because this is a unorganized kind of sector which your data, the ordinary radar doesn't capture it. Okay, so this is one point. So in terms of the very relevant point and which the committee is thinking very, very seriously in terms is that what happens and what kind of employment will you generate for people who are returnees? Yes.
Right.
Okay. So there are two aspects to it. One thing is that they are students also. I think
23, sir. As till yesterday, I think approximately 5,000 to 5,500 persons have entered Sikkim from other parts of country. So the committee right now has no figure details of that. We will take it from the secretary coordination and others that how many of them are students and how many actually employed in some work in different parts of country.
Right, right.
So suppose out of 5,000 persons, on a thumb rule basis, if we say maybe 3,500 were students, so maybe 1,000 to 1,500 or maybe 2,000 persons were employed in other parts of the country. If you see the actual details, the persons who were registered for coming to Sikkim was to the tune of 15,000 plus. So with the opening of the economy, many of them preferred to stay and continue back. So they have not come. So we have to find out the exact numbers, that how many of the 5,000 persons who have returned are have left their job either permanently or temporarily, and it may be the situation improves. No one knows about the COVID, what is there in our future, maybe tomorrow or day after, what will happen, no one knows. Suppose a vaccine comes suddenly, if some medicines comes suddenly, then the entire scenario will change in a moment. I was like just not part of this economic revival. Just I was reading through some of the reports, like Dr. Sam is there, he will speak can with more medical point of view, that there is a Japanese medicine favipiravir, and now Russia has done some modulation in that, and it is supposed that by 8th or 9th they are going to come out of with that medicine, and they are claiming that it is going to be a game changer, that in 4th day the person is okay and by 7th day he is walking and running and jogging, whatever, I don't know, we will have to wait and watch. So our modern world, science, technology, medicine and other things are quite advanced. Thousands and millions of our scientists are working on all those things. So the moment, suppose July the medicine or something comes, or by September the vaccine comes, the situation will be again back to normal. We will be shedding our mask and all those things and leading a normal life. So, but we are not very sure also how the virus will mutate, or all mutants will create what sorts of problem. So we never know, but as I said, we all live in an optimistic world. So we hope that the persons who have come, say 2,000 persons who have left their job temporarily and have come back to Sikkim, and they will be in search of employment and other things. The chairman sahab and our economic advisor and other members, we already are in discussion with the skill development department that how we can do further reskilling of these returnees who have come back to Sikkim, so that they can be employed gainfully in the various works or in the employment which will be generated this post unlockdown period. So skill development department is working, we will also be advising them on the matter, and because those who are working, they have definitely some or other skill. But only thing is, as CM sahab also in his one of the speeches in Samman Bhavan in lockdown has said, that our boys and girls are ready to do certain things outside state, but because of what do they say, they don't want to do it in front of their persons known to them. So this fear of known and unknown has to be, I think, taken out from them. And once they start working in Sikkim also, there is lot of opportunities for such type of employment, because if you see pharma companies and other things, if our boys and girls are ready, there are lot of vacancy. Right now, mostly the persons who are from outside, because they have better technical qualification, they are employed. So through reskilling or other thing, if we do the thing, we can get them gainfully employed in various organized sector as well as unorganized sector in the state. Sir,
I'll just finish. Just to reply to your question, the majority view is that there are so many people coming from outside and there will be unemployment crisis and all. But to tell you very frankly, that all the which I think additional chief secretary sahab has already said, the companies are also eager to have gainful employment, okay, because for them also there are a lot of ancillary companies which provide support to them, okay, like in terms of electrical support and in terms of plant maintenance and in terms of highly skilled kind of thing, which the pharma companies don't do, they outsource it, okay. So the pharma companies also are very eager to I'm sure they are eager that locally in a ancillary service providers develop. So in that sense, they also they also want that employment should be generated. So these kind of opportunities are also there. But to point, to tell you very frankly, what is the idea here is that the idea is a sense of what you call as self-discovery, okay, both for the government as well as for the youth of Sikkim, okay, in terms of new opportunities. So in that sense, it's I think it's very exciting that the new opportunities will be there. But I'm pretty sure that how young boys and girls who are outside, who have been working outside Sikkim, they also technically skilled, okay, they may be working in companies. When they come back, I think this is there, okay. Thank you.
So my name is Sudhir Pradhan, and I just want to know, ARC is already working, meeting any stakeholders, and maybe estimating for the bailout package also. But my question is, what is way out? How you are planning to come up with this crisis? This question is like the plan. The things are already in the pipeline, like inter-district water, homestay development, and the excursion of students already in the pipeline. So, how you are exactly planning to come up from this crisis?
As I already told you before, it is premature for a committee to come up and say this is what we have done, okay, because we haven't heard all the stakeholders. So what I'm asking the press is that whatever, when we hear all the stakeholders and we are convinced that these are genuine problems and this is how we can solve, okay, I'm saying the in the question itself there is the answer, okay. When people question that how we will revive tourism, there is an answer in itself, okay. So the committee for its sake will just structure those answers, and wherever hand holding is needed, as additional chief secretary sahab has said, we'll do the hand holding. These things are there, the government is going to hand hold and take them, okay. Number one. Number two, in terms of wherever there are what you call as gaps in terms of skill, okay, which Secretary Saab has said, wherever there are gaps in terms of what the industry requires, okay, and what our people are, so we intend to do a reskilling mechanism through the skill development department. So this is the role the Economic Revival Committee will play in terms of suggestions and advice to the government and to the stakeholders.
So what are the formidable challenges which committee is facing right now in the entire exercise? Because we know most of the departments are not equipped with a proper database and statistics. We as a press person has to struggle in getting the proper statistics. What are the challenges and what is the way forward for it?
Challenges are many, okay, but just to paraphrase one challenge which is there, the challenge is that how do you now understand the core crux of the problem? Okay, we may say that tourism has hit, okay, because tourists didn't, problems related to tourism, okay. So are we going and understanding the root cause of the problem? So these are the challenges, okay. That is the fear of the committee, that we will point out some other problems which may not be the actual problem, okay. So this is the main challenge. Okay, so this becomes a very important aspect and serious question for the committee. In terms of data, okay, in terms of data, see, no data is accurate. Okay, there is always a question about whether you want perfect data and wait for 10 years for that data to come, and after 10 years the data will not be relevant. Okay, or there is a question that we'll use the existing data which is not very accurate and go forward with the decision. So this is always a problem with data and decision making, okay. But to point it more, to make it more clear, so in this situation, okay, when we have faced a pandemic situation, okay, no prediction said that the world would be one third of the world would shut down, or the world has shut down, okay. So this is not a time and situation where data will show us the way, okay. We have to take a quantum leap of jump of faith and make decisions accordingly. Okay.
I would like to hear from Mr. Dendi.
Good evening, friends. Regarding Economic Revival Committee details, our chairman has apprised you, so I would not like to repeat that. And then the questions you have asked our chairman and the additional chief secretary replied to. You asked one question, I just like to touch general one general question of unemployment. This is again most of my view, but and which I firmly like to believe it. There is unemployment, not only in Sikkim, India, all over the world. Now we'll go to the Sikkim only. This unemployment, I'm like, how far this data is correct? I'm like, it's a big question mark. We don't know how they arrived to this figures. However, little go, I want to go back. Why this unemployment at all in Sikkim is because of certain wrong policies of the previous government. So this government, we like to take a course correction of their policies. Policies like uneven development within Sikkim. Some, like, you know, within Sikkim, there's an unbalanced development. So like such factors, like power sector, we have a lot of potential, but they don't touch, but incomplete power sector. Like that in many other fields. So I think this government, our present government, is committed to course correction of these policies and bring our economic policy for Sikkim and Sikkim's people. Sikkim's people. Like if this, you can make out from there, right after the government coming to the, forming the government by the SKM party, like so many we have done, so many policies announced by the Sikkim government. Like for instance, a lot of areas given to the people, the employees and all. These are, you know, like this empowers the local people. Even not only that, raise the payment to the skilled and unskilled laborers. So this sort of a policy empowers the actual poor Sikkimis, which has been ignored for the last 25 years. This one. Now yes, coming to the now challenges we face, unemployment. Like our chairman, and he said, like when they come, we have a skilled development department, well equipped, with our headed by secretary. So reskill will do that. This thing. Then we like to use other departments also, like corruption department. I see a lot of opportunities for the people, for the local Sikkimese people can lot of benefit from department like cooperative department, corruption department. So we like to utilize these departments. Then then this year, the union budget, if you see nicely, they have given the highest allocation as made on agriculture, education and social welfare. So this government would like to take maximum advantage from this union budget, like for which is very much Sikkim. I'm like, you can take a lot of advantage for our agriculture in Sikkim. Same education. Same in social welfare. Generally, people here are poor. So we can take this advantage from social welfare allocation, from education, and from agriculture. As our chairman said, like the jump in the agriculture activities in Sikkim after the lockdown. So like we like to apprise the people of Sikkim. We like to, our government like to do that, take maximum advantage from even union budget also. And then, presently, the Prime Minister's that announcement, relief announcement, we like to take advantage from that. And like you all know, like a small state, revenue scarcity state, we depend a lot from central government. Now, a small example I'll tell you. What you used to, equipments used to agriculture 50 years back, same still follows today. In villages you go. So, what I mean to say is, we will, you know, like this government will take course correction of all these activities. Like to empower the villagers, village people, poor people. So that this, if you can do that, this will solve the unemployment.
But you will be speaking, we are speaking as a committee.
Yeah, committee, as well as economic advisor also.
You mean to say this will be the recommendation that will be submitted?
No, not recommendation. This is my personal view to some extent.
Okay, and not as a committee?
Yeah, committee. Committee approval, we have got a lot of information. Then it'll be, you know, like sorted out, and then we send a report.
Sir, my additional question is, since this pandemic has bring a lot of transformations from our mindset also, and force us to go for the technologies, how far our the IT sector is capable to handle the post pandemic situation in Sikkim?
Question is directed to me.
specific to information technology and all. See, information technology and technology per se, okay, this is available for everyone. Okay, so any technology anywhere in the world is accessible to Sikkim, provided we have the commitment and provided we have the ability to pay, okay, for the technology. In that sense, Sikkim is no better or no worse than any state in India, okay, for imbibing of technology. Number one. Number two, this is a point which I want to make. Whenever there is chaos, okay, today we are in a situation of chaos. The whole world is in a situation of chaos. In chaos, there is always an opportunity, okay, for newer things to develop and for stability to come. Okay, the challenge for a state like Sikkim, small state like Sikkim, is that how do you come out of this chaos, okay, and how do you reap the benefits from the challenges which are there. Okay, why I'm saying this is because if you look at the stock market, when the stock market is going natural, and when you know the trend of the stock market, there is nothing much to earn. You just put your SIP or whatever, you will earn your normal profit. But whenever the stock market goes through huge swings, there is the opportunity to earn for a very informed investor. So also out here, whenever there is chaos, there is an opportunity for huge recovery and huge improvement. That is why previously I said there is an opportunity for quantum jump. Okay, there is a quantum jump here opportunity. So this is.
Sir, my last question: what is the time frame you'll be submitting your recommendation and a report to the government? I mean, is there any time frame which the government has given you to do the entire exercise?
I think when the committee was first formed, I think the time frame was 1 month. But
is it enough?
It doesn't seem to be enough. Okay, so we'll have to ask more time for it. But definitely, I think within 2 months we'll be able to complete and give the report to the government, comprehensive report to the government.
Sir, what kind of support Sikkim government can expect from center in terms of revenue and tax collection?
See, this is not personally for me to answer. Okay, but to tell you frankly, it is not so much of support which the state, which the committee will recommend in terms of the state. Of course, needs support from the central government in terms of funds and all these things, which are natural course of things. But these are very extenuating circumstances. Of course, financial support, okay, in terms of fiscal support and grants will be very welcome from the central government. This will also form a part of the report. But of as you all know, that the major chunk of the vertical central government's thing is in terms of credit link kind of policies. So it is more beneficial and long term, in terms of, if you look at the long term perspective, it is more beneficial if the state government can, state government with the help of the banks and central government authorities, do a hand holding and help our entrepreneurs and youths to take advantage of it. Okay, so that is the point which you want to carry forward to you.
यसको जवाब तपाईहरुले पहिल्यै दिइसकेको छ त्यहाँ कि वी ऑल नो दैट बाई वेरियस एक्टिविटीज व्हाट आर द सोर्सेज ऑफ रेवेन्यू फॉर एनी गवर्नमेंट लाइक यूनियन गवर्नमेंट हैज इट्स ओन कलेक्शन फ्रॉम GST एक्साइज कॉर्पोरेशन टैक्स दिस दैट सो मेनी टैक्सेस आर देयर इनकम टैक्स ऑल दिस थिंग फॉर्म द पार्ट ऑफ द कॉफर ऑफ द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट नाउ फॉर state government also, we get certain percentage of the total revenue which the government India collects. and the formula is decided by the Finance Commission. So the at present now the 15th Finance Commission has come up with its award for 1 year right now, and for the remaining 4 years it will be declared or awarded in some time in October or November. So Finance Commission has given a percentage or formula that Sikkim will get point so percent of the union budget. So now we were supposed to get funds out of that formula of the Finance Commission. Now, but if the overall total collection which in normal times should have been say X amount, and because of the pandemic and lockdown and all the various issues, this is X minus Y. So our share will also come down proportionately. Instead of say 0.42%, 0.042% of X, we will get 0.042% of say X minus Y. So that is one shortfall which we will get. Now the other source of funding of the government budget for the state is state's own tax and non-tax revenue. There also we had, based on our previous year reports and other things, we have projected a certain figure that this will be our collection of own tax and non-tax revenue. Here also, though in other parts of the country the lockdown has eased out, the works have started, but Sikkim, as a matter of abundant precaution, still we are going from the lockdown phases itself right now also. So the whole of April is gone, the whole of May is gone, till maybe 15th of June has been announced that it will not, major activities will take place. Let us hope that the activities start by say July. So one quarter basically of our revenue has been washed out. So it is a double pronged attack, reduction in the contribution from the government of India from its own share of central taxes, as well as reduction in our own collection of tax and non-tax revenue. Now government of India has given some leeway, very part, that as a part of the announcement of the economic package which PM announced, and then finance minister, union finance minister elaborated on that, they have said that we can amend our FRBM Act, and instead of the 3% of the GSDP, we can go up to 5% of the GSDP. That is, there is an increase in our open market borrowing by 2%. But there also they have put lot many conditions, because when the other party is slightly weak and down, the major shareholder tries to push them further. So they have said that out of 2%, 0.5% you will get unconditional, and remaining 1% you will get by fulfilling 4 reforms. 0.25% weightage has been given for 4 reforms. These reforms are like one nation, one ration card, then ease of doing business, then improving the resource and tax base of the urban local bodies, and reforms in the power sector. So these are the 4 sector reforms. They have given details which the state government have to fulfill, and if we fulfill, then 0.25 for each reform we will get, and if we fulfill 3 out of the 4 reforms, then we will be able to draw the remaining 0.5%, which is unattached right now. So it's a very tedious and difficult process. So this has been taken at the highest level. If all the departments and are in a position to carry out the reforms in the given time frame, we will get some cushion. Now in addition to that, we have also announced certain austerity measures to cut down our expenditure. Right now we have said that there will be a general cut of 20% in our revenue expenditure and 20% cut in capital expenditure. But as the lockdown is being extended, we in the finance department are jittery. Our blood pressures have gone up by I don't know how many points. We are not getting it measured also. So more the lockdown, more the tension in the, at least finance department. Other departments are not feeling the pinch of it right now.
Sir, are you satisfied with the contribution being made by Professor Nana, who in fact is physically not present in the committee? So what is his contribution as one of the members?
No, Professor Lama thing in today's world, which is a IT dominated world, physical presence is not required.
The committee is satisfied with
the like the in all the major sectors and companies which are saying they are allowing work from home. So in all our meetings, Professor Lama is connected through video conference or Skype. We have a big TV, 43 inches, we can see his face and full body in full glory. And his mental inputs are also coming through mails and other things. So lockdown is not a hindrance in Professor Lama not being physically present for with the committee. But in all other aspects, he is fully present with us.
Sir, media house
are
badly affected.
So,
any plan to
revive us? Media houses, sir.
Media has already got first tranche of stimulus. We may call media also to get your views also, because from your point of view, you are overemployed. Media, whether electronic as well as the print media, is in full swing and full business. You are getting printings daily, your telecast is coming daily, ads have not dried up. But anyway, we can have a meeting with media also in one of days, maybe 9th, to hear your views also and to take your memorandum also.
Sir, last two questions on the health sector. Doctor, can you brief us how this pandemic has put us in the challenges in front of in the health sector? And what are the challenges and what would be the future aspects for Sikkim's better health
Okay, so good evening everyone. So this is a challenge. This is a challenge not only for us, it's for everyone. So if you see the history of infectious epidemic, okay, right from the plague, then you have the smallpox, then you have the Spanish flu. Okay, the Spanish flu lasted for around 3 to 4 years, affecting almost all sectors. Then if you see the SARS virus, that which originated from China itself, but that could be contained. Similarly, in 2011-12, you had the MERS originating from Saudi Arabia. Now, few years back, we had Nipah virus, okay, Nipah virus from Kerala, and that we could contain. And now you have this virus, which is very, very infectious, very infectious, though its mortality is less. It's not as compared to that of SARS or MERS, which was about 30 to 40%. So here we have a mortality to about 3 to 5%, okay. So definitely it has affected almost all sectors. Even the health sector has been affected, especially the private sector. So this is a time where we need to introspect ourselves and see what we can do in a long run, in a future, how we need to go about. So basically it has put us everybody into that strain, okay. So this is a time where we need to introspect, and moreover we don't know much about the virus, how it's going to go up. And now you are hearing that now it's time you need to live with the virus, okay. You should learn the methods, various methods by which you should learn how to live with the virus. So we don't know about the vaccine, when it's coming. So any vaccine, it would take definitely 12 months or more for it to have a success. And here recently we heard that whatever the early vaccine that was developed, that was only 50% which had 50% potential. Okay. And the drugs which are coming up, like the hydroxychloroquine, which was such a big hype few months back, but now it has totally gone down. Similarly, there are various drug trials in basically antiviral drugs, but they are not coming in that big way. So basically now it's time we need to wait. And gradually you open up, and if you see, we have opened up to a great extent, isn't it? If you see, except for a few segments, otherwise other segments are gradually opening up. So it's basically what we see and how it's going to play out. So only the time is going to tell.
Doctor, since Sikkim is a landlocked state, and it's most of its health services depends upon the other states, how could we tackle these situations and what are the challenges in the health sectors?
Yeah, definitely. If you see the amount of referral that has compared to previous years has subsequently come down, except for some major health issues. Otherwise, around 70 to 80% now it can be taken care in state itself. Okay, so that's what I was telling, that this is the time where we need to introspect ourselves and come out with a solution where we were lacking, and we need to build ourselves. So definitely, as we saw 5-10 years back, where almost 50% had to go down to Siliguri or to Calcutta or Delhi, but that level has definitely come down, and maybe in a years to come that also will be trying to bring it to absolutely less than 5%.
Health facility.
Yeah, health facilities that we are lacking, definitely we need to work over this area, but definitely over the years we have brought it to subsequent to low level, but definitely we need to do a lot in this sector. We have to do a lot.
Thank you.